Is identity shaped more by genetics or environment? It's nature versus nurture. A lecture today called Identical Strangers Complements Identity, an Exhibition of You. It's all at the Durham. John Sullivan is an education specialist there. Sisters and authors, Paula Bernstein and Elyse Shein, join us as well. It's nice to have you here. Good to see you, John.
Thanks for having us.
But I want to start with your story. Why were you separated at birth?
Good question. We were each adopted by different families who were not told that we were twins. And at the time, the adoption agency had the theory that twins would be better off if they were raised separately, and they did not tell either sets of parents.
This was part of a study with a couple of researchers heading it up. How did you find out that you were part of this program along with some other sets of twins and a set of triplets, right?
Well, when I was finally ready to find out more about my birth family, then I contacted the adoption agency, and they told me that we had been, when I asked why we had been separated, they said that we were part of a twin study, which of course I found very disturbing. And I set out to find Paula, who didn't even know, you know, at that point she didn't know she had a twin.
What did you think when you not only realized you had an identical twin, but that you were a science experiment?
It was disturbing, obviously, to feel as if I didn't know the truth about my origins, about my history, about our lives had been, there was this feeling that our lives had been orchestrated, that it suddenly made me question everything. And it does tap into this issue of identity.
Of identity, and you've written a book about this, right? Nature versus nurture. What have you discovered throughout your personal experiences and the process of writing the book?
Well, there are some amazing similarities we never would have imagined. For example, you could see we have similar mannerisms, even though we were reared apart. So in a way, we conducted our own twin study by getting to know each other and by writing the book together immediately after meeting each other, which was quite challenging. We often joked the book might end with us killing each other.
Do you get along well? Do you love each other? What is your relationship like?
I'm sure we'd each have different answers, but I think I can safely say we love each other. I think we both agree. You know, I think it's still complicated getting to know each other. It has been 10 years. And we've definitely had our ups and downs. And as Elyse said, writing the book was definitely like one intense therapy session.
What did we find out through the study, these researchers? What did they conclude?
That's the crazy thing, that after conducting the study, they, by the time they had enough data, they realized, of course, that the public outcry would be too great if they published it. So in fact, the findings are sealed. So we never do find out the results, but as Elyse said, we did conduct sort of our own informal study.
And it's really incredible to see another person with your face. So after growing up separately, and we were both adopted, and so we were unique in our families, and then meeting another version of yourself with the same DNA, who has made different choices, who has become a different person. I think it was really startling to discover that and compare. And we went to very intense comparisons about, why do you like that kind of food? Maybe it's because I had that upbringing. So we're both quite analytical.
Well, and then good thing, because you wrote this book, which some of these other sets of twins I've read don't even know about each other or about the study still. Have you tried to get the word out or connect with these other unknowingly participants?
Well, we did touch base. There were 13 individuals in this study. There were four sets of twins and one set of triplets. And so we did make contact with the surviving ones. Unfortunately, some of these twins, once they found out, the reunions did not go well. And there was some tragedy, which you can read about in the book. But as far as we know, there may still be one twin set out there who don't know, but we don't have the right to interrupt their lives.
Of course. I mean, and the researchers, have you talked to them about why they did it? And then John, we'll get to you. I'm just so fascinated by this.
Fascinating story.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
It's interesting because even at that time, it was not accepted for other adoption agencies to separate twins. Whenever possible, they would keep twins together. And the researchers were really playing God and really thought they knew better. And thought they, I think they thought they were doing the right thing.
Are they apologetic now?
Not at all. No, we did luckily get the chance to meet the main researcher, and he still seemed convinced that he did the right thing.
John, how does their story, and there's a lecture tonight, so if you're just as fascinated by this stranger than fiction sort of story. You'll be speaking at the Durham this evening. But how does this tie into the new exhibition which just opened?
Yep, Identity and Exhibition of You. I think this story really does fit in so well with the exhibit itself. Elyse and Paula's story is so unique, just like the experience that everyone's going to have as they go through. And there are bits and pieces in the exhibit that are going to talk about the genetics and how, what percentage is it that people in your own family are going to have similar identities or genetic makeup.
The mannerisms, yes. The example goes yes. here. Yep. Mm-hmm. What should our viewers do if they would like to attend the lecture?
Well, I tell you what, this topic is so fascinating that seats are filling up very quickly. So if they call the museum, 402-444-5071.
Great, and there's the number.
Get your name on the reservation list. A reservation is required, but seats are filling up fast. So definitely get your name on that list quickly.
It starts at 6:30. There is a reception as well. Mm-hmm. A book signing, too. You'll have copies of the book there in
That's
case
right.
Our viewers would like to meet the twins and get a copy of the book signed, read all about it. It's so fascinating, but my heart is with you, that your lives, it seems, were so full, but then to have this curveball, it's unimaginable. Learn more about the exhibit, by the way, online. It's open through
January 11th.
So you've got some time, but it's durhammuseum.org. Thank you both.
Thank
Good to see you.
Again.
Thank you.
Well.